Good morning, children. Today we'll discuss about vibrations of a linear triatomic molecule. Let us go with the presentation. Vibrations of a linear triatomic molecule. So here we'll consider triatomic molecule of type AB2. For example, here we'll consider carbon dioxide. So A type here we'll consider C, and B2 type here we are considering oxygen. That means here we'll consider 3 atoms. So triatomic molecule which we are arranged in a linear way, which we are arranged in a linearly here. So here we will consider the vibrations of a linear triatomic molecule. And here let us consider 3 atoms of type B type. Here we are considering 2 atoms, and A type here it is a single atom. And here these atoms are here we are arranged in a linear way, and here we are arranging these by using the springs. Here we are connecting these by using springs of force constant K. So here the interatomic force between the atoms A and B is the approximately by the elastic force of spring force constant K. Here we have the spring force constant K here. So the motion of the 3 atoms is constrained. So here we are constraining the motion of the 3 atoms, and here we are constrained along the line joining them here. So here there are 3 coordinates marking the positions of the 3 atoms. Here we have here 3 coordinates for marking the positions of 3 atoms here of this particular line. So if x1, x2, x3 are the positions of 3 atoms at any instant for some arbitrary origin, then let us see this figure here. So this is A, B, B, and here B with mass M, and here A with mass capital M, and here the force constants between these A, B are K, and here we have the positions x1, x2, x3, and here the distance between A to B it is x0, and from here also distance between A to B it is x0, and here the distance here it is x01, and from here B to again from the initial state to the middle atom here the distance it is x02, and from initial to the final atom here the distance it is x03, and here we are constraining the motion along the line joining them. And here let us see, that means here longitudinal oscillations, we can observe only the longitudinal oscillations between these atoms here. So longitudinal oscillations of a linear symmetric triatomic molecule, and here first one, this is equilibrium configuration. So here it is the equilibrium configuration, and here this is the configuration at any instant t. So this is in the state of rest, which is in the equilibrium position, and here this is the at any instant t here. And here these atoms, so already we have constraint here. So whenever we are giving some vibrations, so it will move linearly. And here we can observe here the distance, here it is x1 and here x2. So these are the position coordinates here, x1, x2 and x3. And here the coordinates here, it is q1 and here it is q2 and here it is q3. And here if you observe here for this equilibrium configuration, x2 minus x1, if you see x2 minus x1, we will obtain x0. And from here x3 to x2, x3 minus x2 will obtain again x0. That means here x0 is constant. If you subtract x2 to x1 or x3 to x2, it is the distance is constant here, x0. And here q1 is equals to xi minus x0i. So here qi is equals to xi minus x0i. So here we have the, if x1, x2, x3 are the positions of the 3 atoms at any instant from some arbitrary origin, here we have considered the origin, then kinetic energy equals to half m x1 dot square plus x3 dot square plus half m x2 dot square. So here these are the velocities. So this is the kinetic energy, t equals to half m x1 dot square plus x3 dot square plus half m x2 dot square. And this is for the single molecule atom, and these are for the 2 atoms, so x1, x3. So here potential energy equals to half k into x2 minus x1 minus x0 whole square plus half k into x3 minus x2 minus x0 whole square. So here we have x naught is constant. If you observe, x2 minus x1 equals to x naught, x3 minus x2 equals to x naught. So x naught is constant. That's why we can leave this. We can leave this x naught term. So no need of this to write this x naught term. We can leave this x naught term. So here x naught is the distance between A and B atoms in the equilibrium configuration. So let us define the generalized coordinates. So here we have generalized coordinates. We have q1, q2, q3, and q1 equals to x1 minus x01, q2 equals to x2 minus x02, q3 equals to x3 minus x02, x03. So these are the generalized coordinates where x2 minus x1, which is equals to x3 minus x1, which is equals to constant x0. So then kinetic energy T equals to half. So let us substitute here. So here q1 equals to x1 minus x01, q2 equals to x2 minus x02. So here by seeing these by using these generalized coordinates, kinetic energy half m into q dot square plus q3 dot square plus half m q dot q2 dot square. That means we are replacing the generalized coordinates here, because here x naught it is constant here. That means q1 equals to x1, q2 equals to x2, q3 equals to x3. So in the same way, potential energy is equals to half k into q2 minus q1 whole square plus half k into q3 minus q2 whole square. So this is the potential energy. Then T and V matrices. So by using these T and V, we can form the matrices. By using kinetic energy and potential energy, we write the matrices for this T and this V. So these are the matrices M, 0, 0, 0, capital M, 0, 0, 0, M. This is for kinetic energy, kinetic energy. And for potential energy, by using the equation, by using this equation, we'll obtain the matrix as K minus K, 0, minus K, 2K, minus K, 0, minus K, K. So the secular equation, we have the formula, secular equation is V minus omega square. This is T, not I. So here this is a printing mistake. So V minus omega square into T. That means secular equation, we have V minus omega square T equals to. So if you consider this V and omega, omega square, we are multiplying with omega into kinetic energy. This is the secular equation. V minus omega square T is equals to this one. So which is equals to the determinant is equals to 0. So by finding out this determinant, we'll obtain this one. So hence omega square k minus m omega square into k into m plus 2m minus omega square capital M into small m, which is equals to 0. So this is the, by finding this determinant, we will obtain this one. So this will obtain by using v minus omega square t. That means we are subtracting from V by omega square into T. So by multiplying this one with T, and we have to subtract from V. So V minus omega square T equals to this one. So the determinant after calculation will obtain this one. The solutions of this equation are, so the solutions for this equation of omega 1 equals to 0, omega 2 equals to root of K by M, omega 3 equals root of K by M into 1 plus 2M by M. So these are the solutions for the above equations. So the first eigenvalue omega 1. So here omega 1, omega 2, omega 3 are the eigenvalues. So the first eigenvalue omega 1 equals to 0, which corresponds to the non-oscillatory motion. That means in the and refers to the translatory motion of the molecule as a whole rigidly. So if eigenvalue omega 1 equals to 0, which is the non-oscillatory motion. So to determine the eigenvectors, we use. So here to determine the eigenvectors, we use. So V minus omega k square T into AK equals to 0. So here we will find out the eigenvectors by using the equation V minus omega k square T AK equals to 0. Or if you substitute this one, so already we have V minus omega square T, already we have this one into. So just write this one. AK, so A1K, A2K, A3K, which is equals to 0. So this is the to find out the eigenvectors. So this is the equation to find out the eigenvectors. So let us now discuss the eigenvectors for the three modes of the vibrations. So for omega 1 equals to 0, so if we substitute omega 1, so if we consider omega 1 equals to 0, so we will obtain k minus k 0 minus k 2k minus k 0 minus k k. So if you substitute here for omega 1 equals to 0, so here we have omega term, it will become 0. Here we will have k. So here we do minus k, and here again here omega term, here omega 1 0, that means here we have, yeah, we'll obtain here 2k, and here also we have omega term, so here also we'll obtain k. So by substituting omega 1 equals to 0 in this equation, we'll obtain k minus k 0 minus k 2k minus k 0 minus k k into again here k, it is k value, here we are replacing 1, so a11, a21, a31, so which is equals to 0. So by multiplication we'll obtain a11 minus a21 equals to 0 minus a11 plus 2a21 minus a31 equals to 0 minus a21 plus a31 equals to 0. So by multiplication we'll obtain this one, and a11 equals to alpha, a21 equals to alpha, a31 equals to alpha, that means a11 equals to a21 equals to a31 equals to alpha. So thus for omega 1 equals to 0, eigenvector is given by, so eigenvector will obtain finally, so a11, a21, a31 equals to, so here alpha, 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 alpha. So for omega 1 equals to 0, we will obtain the eigenvector a1 equals to alpha, alpha, alpha. Suppose if you substitute omega 2 equals to 0, omega 2 equals to root of k by m in the above equation, that means in this equation, we will obtain omega 2 equals to root of k by m, we will obtain this one, 0 minus k 0 minus k 2k minus mk by m minus k 0 minus k 0 a12 a22 a32 equals to 0. So by multiplying, by multiplying this one, we will obtain a22 equals to 0 minus a12 minus a32 equals to 0. So therefore a22 equals to 0, a12 equals to minus a32 equals to, let it be beta. So for omega 2 equals to root of k by m, we'll obtain eigenvector a2 equals to beta 0 beta. So beta 0 beta minus beta. So here we'll obtain this one. And for omega 3 equals to root of k by m into 1 plus 2m by m, if you substitute this one again in this equation, we'll obtain 2mk minus 2mk by capital M minus k 0 minus k minus k m by m minus k 0 minus k 2mk by m into a13 a23 a33 equals to 0. So by multiplication this one, we'll obtain 2m by m a13 plus a23 equals to 0, a13 plus m by m into a23 plus a33 equals to 0, a23 plus 2m by m a33 equals to 0. So by multiplication we'll obtain this one. Therefore, a13 equals to a33, which we will obtain alpha, and a23 equals to minus 2m by m into alpha. So thus, for omega 3 equals to root of km into 1 plus 2m by m, we will obtain a3 equals to eigenvector a3 equals to gamma minus 2m by m into gamma. Now let us consider the matrix. So A is equals to a11, a12, a13, a21, a22, a23, a31, a32, a33. Which is equals to, now let us substitute all these terms. So already we have the eigenvectors a1, a2, a3. So just simply replace. So here eigenvector a1 equals to, we got alpha, alpha, alpha. Eigenvector a2, beta, 0, beta. And here a3 equals to gamma minus 2m by m into gamma, gamma. So let us substitute here. So this is the matrix A. So alpha, 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 beta, 0, minus beta, gamma minus 2m by m into gamma, into gamma. So we impose the condition, already we have A inverse T, that here T is the kinetic energy. We have A inverse T, A is equals to I. So let us find out this one. So A transpose, that means we have to, this is the value of A, by writing the transpose of this one, that means alpha, beta, gamma. So we'll write like this. So alpha 0 minus 2m by m into gamma, we'll write like this. Alpha minus beta gamma, we'll write like this. So into kinetic energy, already we have in the just write that one, m 0 0 0 capital M 0 0 0 M, and A we have this one as it is, we'll write this one, and I equals to 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So by multiplication this one we'll obtain, by solving this one we'll obtain this one, alpha square into 2m plus m 0 0 0 2 beta square m 0 0 0 2 gamma square m into 1 plus 2m by m, which is equals to I 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Thus from this one alpha equals to 1 by root of 2m plus m, beta equals to 1 by root of 2m, gamma equals to 1 by 2m root of 2m into 1 plus 2m by m. So these are the alpha value, beta value, gamma value. So hence the given vectors are a1 equals to this one 1 by root of 2m plus m into 1 1 1. So a2 equals to 1 by root of 2m into 1 0 minus 1. a3 equals to 1 by root of this one root of 2m into 1 plus 2m by m into 1 1 minus 2m by m into 1. So these are the eigenvectors. Hence the eigenvectors, a1 value this one, a2 values final eigenvectors are this one, a3 equals to this one. So by solving this one, we'll obtain these values. Now let us consider. So thus in the case 1, if we consider the case 1 here, see, so B, A, B. So here a11 equals to a21 equals to a31 means that these atoms, the displacements of these three atoms are the same, in the same direction. So we can observe all these displacements of these atoms are in the same direction. So this is figure which are in the same direction. So this is what expected from the translatory motion. Already we have considered the linear motion of translatory motion. This is the expected condition. So we have a11 equals to a21 equals to a31 means this is the condition. And if we consider this one, so here a22 equals to 0 means this one. So a12 equals to minus a32. That means here we can observe that. So here a22 0 means middle term. The middle term does not vibrate. It is in the state of rest position. And the end atoms, these are oscillate with equal amplitudes. These are with equal amplitude, but in opposite direction. Both are in the opposite direction. So both are in opposite direction. And if you consider the case 3, a13 equals to a33 equals to gamma, and a23 equals to minus 2m by m into gamma. That means here, these shows that the end atoms oscillate in phase with equal amplitudes. So these end atoms, they oscillate in phase with equal amplitudes, while the central atom vibrates in the opposite phase with different amplitude. This one with different amplitude. So here, these are the three cases which we have observed here from those eigenvectors, and the generalized coordinates q1, q2, q3 are the related to the normal coordinates capital q1, capital q2, capital q3 by using the relation. So we have the relation for the capital normal coordinates and the generalized coordinates qi equals to sigma k equals to 1 to 3 aik capital qk, where here I equals to 1 comma 2 comma 3. Therefore q1, q2, q3 equals to alpha, beta, gamma, beta 0 minus 2m by m into gamma, gamma minus beta, gamma into q1, q2, q3. So for the normal coordinate, q1 oscillates with the frequency omega 1 equals to 0, q2 with omega 2 equals to root of k by m, and q1 with omega 3 equals to root of k by m, 1 plus 2m by m. So here for normal coordinates, q1 oscillates with the frequencies already which we have seen. So omega 1 0, omega 2 root of k by m, with omega 3 root of k by m into 1 plus 2m by m, so that q1 equals to f1 cos omega 1 t plus phi 1, q2 equals to f2 cos omega 2 t plus phi 2, and q3 equals to f3 cos omega 3 t plus phi 3. So here f1, it is the amplitude. Here f1, f2, f3 are the amplitude, and here omega 1, it is frequency of the first particle, omega 2 it is the frequency of the second particle, omega 3 it is the frequency of the third particle. So here f1 it is the amplitude, f2 amplitude, f3 it is the amplitude. So here by using normal coordinates oscillate with the frequencies omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, q1 equals to this one, q2, q3. So thus q1 equals to alpha f1 cos omega 1 t plus phi 1 plus beta f2 cos omega t omega 2 t plus phi 2 plus gamma f3 cos omega 3 t plus cos 3. So here, now let us find out the x1, x2, x3 terms. So now let us write the x1. So here q1, it is the coordinate, position coordinate. So generalized coordinate. So x1, it is the position coordinate. Now let us write. So here, if you substitute omega 1 equals to 0, first let us write the q1. So this is a q1. Let us write the x1. So here alpha f1 is nothing but capital A. Alpha f1 is, we are replacing with capital A, cos omega 1 t plus phi 1 plus we are replacing beta f2 with capital B, cos omega 2 t plus phi 2, and gamma f3 we are replacing with capital C, f cos omega 3 t plus phi 3 plus x 0 1. So here this is the x1. But we have omega 1 equals to 0. So if you substitute omega 1 equals to 0 in this equation, we'll obtain. So here in the first term, omega 1 0 means here we'll have a cos phi 1. So a cos omega 1 here 0 means a cos omega 1 t equals to 0. And if you multiply with a cos phi 1, so a cos phi 1 is nothing but a dash. We are writing a cos phi 1 with a dash plus b cos omega 2 t plus phi 2 plus c cos omega 3 t plus phi 3 plus x 0 1. So this is x 1. If you consider x 2, already we have a dash term like this. And here, if you can observe here, we have 0 here. Here we have 0. So here b term becomes 0. So that means here we are writing by seeing this one. So here b term, it is 0. So we are vomiting, we are leaving. And here in the case of c term, we have minus 2m by capital M. So gamma quotient here, we have minus 2m by capital M. So we are writing here minus 2m by capital M into c cos omega 3 t plus phi 3 plus x 0 2. And x3 equals to a dash, already we are keeping like this. And b term, here we have minus beta. So we are writing minus b cos omega 2 t plus phi 2 as it is we are writing plus c cos. So in here we have 1 here. So c cos omega 3 t plus phi 3 plus x 0 3. So here a dash represents the constant corresponding to the rigid translation and x 0 I. X 0 I is the equilibrium position of an atom. Here x 0 I, it is, that means x 0 1, x 0 2, x 0 3. So here the equilibrium position of the atom. So thus we observe from the equation 11 that any general longitudinal vibration of a molecule, if it does not involve a rigid translation, is some linear combination of the normal modes omega 2 and omega 3. So the amplitudes of the normal modes and their phases related to each other may be determined by the initial conditions. Thank you, children.